Abominable is the latest animation adventure comedy from DreamWorks, featuring the voice work of Chloe Bennett, Albert Tsai, Tenzing Norgay Trainer, Eddie Izzard, and Sarah Paulson, amongst many others. It is written and directed by Jill Coulton. This story is about how a young girl helps a mythical creature return home to his family in the Himalayas. A yeti escapes from a highly guarded lab, only to be discovered by Yi, voiced by Chloe Bennett, on the roof of her apartment building. The young girl ends up befriending the mysterious being, long believed to be mere folklore, naming him Everest because he indicates that his home is in the Himalayas. But a billionaire mountaineer, Burnish, who is voiced by Eddie Izzard, has spent a lifetime trying to prove the Yeti's existence to the world. With the assistance of Dr. Zara, voiced by Sarah Paulson, the old explorer chases down Everest after his escape. Yi is compelled to protect Everest. Peng, voiced by Albert Tsai, Jin, voiced by Tenzing Norgay Trainer, and the determined Yi embark on a journey to reunite Everest with his family in the Himalayas. This premise may sound familiar, and you're right, it is. It is a mishmash of various films, most particularly E.T. and How to Train Your Dragon. But writer and director Jill Coulton puts together the winning elements of those films to make Abominable mostly enjoyable. This film has three precocious but affable kids, an endearing clumsy beast, colorfully vivid animation, and a sentimental soundtrack, especially for Coldplay fans. All these ingredients are tried and tested. You know they work, you know why they work, and it's no surprise that they work here too. It's also no surprise that the computer animation by DreamWorks is top-notch. Although the film tends to come across as a Chinese tourism advert, with the country's natural beauty vividly captured in exquisite detail. Still, the film's heart is in the right place. Abominable is a story about connecting with your loved ones, a story that has no geographical boundaries, and that's the best aspect about it. Coming to the cast, Eddie Izzard is particularly distinguishable as Burnish, the billionaire who can afford anything he pleases. Instead, he seeks the acceptance of those who shunned his claims of the Yeti's existence. On the other hand, Sarah Paulson masterfully disappears behind Dr. Zara, who cares about saving the fabled creature instead. The three kids, Yi, Peng, and Jin, make a convincing case as childhood friends, thanks to spirited performances by Chloe Bennett, Albert Tsai, and Tenzing Norgay Trainer respectively, who work well with each other. Some of the best scenes feature them together with Everest. And that's a good thing because a large portion of the film revolves around them. Everest, the magical, mythical Yeti, will probably become a merchandising frontrunner with his inherent furry cuddliness. It definitely helps that he acts like a giant puppy, and he has magical powers. The film is slightly ambiguous about how they work, and you may wonder why the powers aren't used more often. Besides that, all the character beats are predictable each step of the way. But hey, this isn't one of those movies to cross-section and analyze. It's meant to be a fun family outing. And I can see younger kids really enjoying this movie, with older audiences finding enough joy in it as well. That's why I'm going with 3.5 stars for Abominable. It's cute, funny enough with ample visual dazzle. The narrative's focus on human sensitivity towards nature and family values are bound to win hearts of all ages. Guys, thanks so much for watching this review. For more film reviews, interviews, and box office stories, keep watching, because if it's entertainment, you'll find it here on E! Now.